Hello, my name is Fräulein Maria. I am here to announce the Nobel Prize in Literature with the rest of my sex offender friends.
Bob Dylan.
Well, gentlemen, the time fast approaches. All the famous and very uncontroversial Swedish men will gather in their immaculate Nazi towers, read a couple of books, and be like, he's European, let's give him a prize. It's the Nobel Prize in Literature, baby. Some of the best authors have gotten it. Gabriel Garcia Marquez, ooh. Tomas Tranströmer, ooh. Svetlana Alexievich, ooh. Solzhenitsyn, Sholokhov, and Pasternak, ooh. They've also given the award to, So it's really anybody's game. So all the bookie sites for the Nobel Prize have touted the same people for fucking centuries. Some of them are more likely than others. A lot of the shit they decide is very out of left field. I don't think Sienkiewicz or Winston Churchill would win in this day and age, and Kazuo Shiguro wouldn't win 50 years ago. Tolstoy was snubbed for Sally Prodhum, who the fuck is this? Peter Handke, a Srebrenica denier and conspiracy theorist who has written basically nothing, won, and every Central European's head was like, fuck. The award's opening up, and I've incorporated that into my rankings. I'm gonna make the very bold prediction that despite what I say here, I think the next winner is gonna be from Asia, and most likely from China, Japan, or Korea.
Hello. Welcome to the Nobel Prize in Literature. Let me tell you exactly why Ladbrokes is wrong and how best to win money. This is so fucking bad.
But first, I'll say the five that I really want to win at any point. Any of these five, Swedish Academy and Bob Dylan, will be forgiven. Number one, Cormac McCarthy. I don't think there's any fucking chance this guy's gonna win. They wouldn't award two Americans in a row for a start, and apparently the Nobel Academy have seen The Counselor, which he wrote, and I mean...
She does this full split, and then she starts rubbing herself up and down on the glass. Then she leans down to see if I'm watching. Like, no, I'm sitting there reading my email.
Also, he does this thing that Sally Rooney does where he doesn't have quotation marks because he's like a 20-year-old woman. But some of his books are really awesome. And he's dominated a specific genre, which I love. I think he's like the best Western writer that's still working and writing. And he's very subversive in that way. He's also really fucking old, so he does kind of deserve it. Maurice Kond. Maurice is actually like number one in a lot of the polls, especially I think Ladbrokes has her at number one or like tied with all the rest of them. But she's kind of already won it. They had this prize in 2018 called the New Academy Prize. They had to establish it because the like Nobel Committee were doing a whole bunch of very naughty Swedish things to women. Given she won that, I think it's unlikely she'll get the Nobel Prize now, although she really does deserve it. Sega was great. Also, speaking about this new Academy Prize, I think there's something to be mentioned here because the nominees were Maurice Kond, Haruki Murakami, Kim Toy, don't know who the fuck that is, and fucking Neil Gaiman. What the fuck? If Neil Gaiman ever wins this, or any award that, like, good authors have won, I'm gonna commit an atrocity so bad that Peter Handke will claim it never happened. Hilary Mantel. Mantel is too good a writer for the world she currently lives in. Wolf Hall is dense, it's such a pain in the ass, but it's so good, and I just want to read it again the more I think about it, even though it infuriated me. The Last in the Cromwell trilogy, which is her big one, came out last year, I think. So it's totally possible that she could get it this year as like a congratulations, you've written the best historical trilogy ever. Ko Un. Mr. Un's an excellent Buddhist writer, very Tranströmery. If you haven't read Flowers of a Memory, it's fucking fantastic, legitimately, so please do. Yeah, there's something about it, like his writing, that's really earnest and universal. And I think he's got a good chance, but I'll talk about him in my actual list in a sec. It's the type of poetry that's like the exact opposite of Rupi Kaur's bullshit, because it's so authentic and it comes from a place that's so different to the one that I live in that I find it interesting, both the poetry itself and the context of it. Whereas Rupi Kaur just insists on all of that and doesn't deliver at all.
Could I ask you to maybe read something for us tonight?
Yeah.
Is that okay?
Yeah. Let's do this.
Okay. I like that one. That is
okay. They convinced me I only had a few good years left.
Before, I was replaced by a girl younger than me. As though men yield power with age, but women grow into irrelevance. They can keep their lies, for I have just gotten started. I feel as though I just left the womb. My 20s are the warm-up for what I'm really about to do.
All right, so they're the good authors. Now let's talk about the pretentious authors. So here are some of my picks, in no particular order. Here are my predictions for the Nobel Prize in Literature. Anne Carson is a 70-something-year-old woman. She's written a whole lot of ancient mythology-related works. I've read more of her stuff than anyone else on this list. She wrote Autobiography of Red and Red Doc, both of which are pretty good, although they're so, so pretentious, but they are very good. She translated a lot of Sappho, and that's really great. That's like the preeminent sapphic translation. Ooh, do I sound pretentious? Ooh, fuck. She's also written about her husband and how beautiful he is, or whatever the fuck that's called. She's written, Knox, and she does a lot of like essays and poetries that she kind of combines into books and sends out. She is number one in most of the lists I see, but I don't see her getting it. It's so uninviting and it's kind of one note. Like she hasn't developed as a writer. And I know that sounds like an asshole thing to say, but it's like the differences between Autobiography of Red and Red Doc in terms of like the quality is almost non-existent. Like they're basically the same thing. So she's just very consistent. I'll say consistent, not one note. I think consistent's a better word. But she is very uninviting and it's just comes off as like university lecturer shit.
And can balance the top heaviness of their bodies by plating their feet as they walk.
I mean, if she won, my reaction would kind of be like, cool, you know, like, that's a good pick. And I'd finish reading all of her stuff, and then I'd post a long-winded thing on Instagram about how I knew this would happen, and I've read her stuff and you haven't, so that means I'm more intelligent than you. Things like that.
John is in a basement, mixing up the medicine. I'm on the pavement, thinking about the government.
Jamaica Kincaid is a Caribbean-American author, and she writes a lot of really old-school kind of like classic novels, like things that you would be made to read in school if people knew she existed. So books like Annie John and A Small Place and things like that. I've read half of Annie John. I have not finished it yet. I've got a whole fucking shelf of these books and most of the ones that are coming up are on that shelf and I'm halfway through it. It's good. It's not my pick. I get why she's at the top. I totally get it. She is non-European and she writes as a non-European, which means she could win. But all of her stuff has very European themes and styles, and it's about those kind of concepts that Europeans tend to write about, or at least Europeans who get the award. If she got it, people would read her stuff and then be like, yeah, okay, yeah, at least you're being consistent. yeah, that wouldn't be a bad pick.
A man in a trench coat, flat job laid off, says he's got a bad call.
I'm reading A Heart So White at the moment, and it's really good, and he has the Nobel style completely down, and I am shocked that he isn't higher. It's the same way I feel about some of the authors on the list where I'm like, oh, they haven't won yet? Like, it's so obvious to me that they could get it. And I think they have the kind of standing where that would be fine. Like, I think he could get it, and it would be fine. It wouldn't be a controversy like Peter Handke or something like that would. Javier Marias, I'm gonna give him a 7 out of 10. Are we doing ratings now? He's getting a 7 out of 10. Haruki motherfucker Murakami. He is your resident surrealist cunt. He flirts with pretentious bullshit and he never feels the need to explain it, but it's not in a satisfying way. It's in a, I know you didn't mean this, I know none of this matters, you're a fucking asshole. He's a marathon runner, apparently. He was a nominee for the new Academy Award that Maurice Kond got, and he's also a nominee for the Bad Sex in Literature Award. Here is his nominated passage. My ejaculation was violent and repeated. Again and again, semen poured out of me, overflowing her vagina, turning the sheet sticky. There was nothing I could do to make it stop. If it continued, I worried, I would be completely emptied out. Yuzu slept deeply through it all, without making a sound, her breathing even. Her sex, though, had contracted around mine and would not let go, as if it had an unshakable will of its own and was determined to wring every last drop from my body. I wonder if this man has fucked before. Is Murakami a sex havoc? Because the evidence here points to no. What does he mean about the sex contracting around his? Why has he emptied out his entire life essence into this? Why is she sleeping? Look, I tried Norwegian wood. I promise I did. I really did. But I could not stand it. I just couldn't. It's so annoying. I fucking hate his style of writing. It's so pretentious, and it sounds like it comes from someone who's never had struggle in their life. He's like Rupi Kaur. Honestly, I don't see any difference between him and Rupi Kaur. It's just that he has more standing. Like, there's so many good quotes on, like, if you scroll through, I think it's Goodreads, his, like, quotes section. It's really funny. Everyone may be ordinary, but they're not normal. I actually follow a page on Facebook called Joker's Motivational Quotes, where you take a random bullshit sentence and you edit in, like, Heath Ledger's face smiling, or, like, fucking, Jared Leto lying with the knives around him, and it's like profound, but like ironically, it's like anti-humor. This could get put on that page and nobody would notice. Anyway, if are we doing ratings, I'm gonna give Haruki Murakami a 4 out of 10. Am I rating on how I like them or likelihood that he'll get it? Because I think it's very likely he'll get it because he's like a complete asshole. I'm gonna say, for the likelihood that he gets it, I'm gonna give him a 7 out of 10 as well. This is one of the ones where I don't understand why they're not being talked about more, because a lot of Nobel Prize winners really don't win for having written a lot. They write 3 or 4 masterpieces, and then people just give it to them because that's like their life's work, and they ignore the bad shit that they've written. I feel like Ishiguro is kind of a good example of that, because he's written a lot, but people tout Remains of the Day and Never Let Me Go, and that's kind of it. And people are like, yeah, he deserves it, give it to him. And Michael Ondaatje, writer of The English Patient, and that's the only one I can think of. But like The English Patient, they'd so love to give it to him for that. The English Patient won the Gold Man Booker, which is like the Booker of Bookers. It's like the best man Booker winner. And it's hard to argue with because it's really good. he's kind of like the English speaking Patrick Modiano, who won in, I think, 2013 or 14. And I do feel the same way about him that I do about Cormac McCarthy, in that he's hiding in plain sight. So I'm gonna give him a 6 because there's no talk that they are reading his stuff. But I mean, like, why not give it to him? Why, there aren't worse picks. A man in a pinskin cap in a pig pen wants $11 bills. You only got 10. I feel like if they're going to give the award to a proper poet again, it's not going to be a Western one after Louise Gluck. And Ko-un seems like the one that they would totally go towards. There's a few others in the Asian market, people like Kanzu and Yan Liangqi, that could also get it, but I think he's the most likely, even though there are some substantive sexual assault allegations that have been put forward towards him. That could be a factor, of course. But Peter Handke generated controversy, and their reaction was decidedly, we don't care. I think if I were to lock in one pick as my absolute, like, go-to, like, that's the one. That's the one that I would put money on. I'm gonna give him a 9 out of 10. She's the big Russian writer on the polls. People say that she continues the same sort of epic style that people like Pasternak and Solzhenitsyn were engaging in at points in their lives. I read the front half of The Big Green Tent about 3 years ago, and I didn't understand a fucking word. I think I will go back to it, especially if she wins. But she's top of the polls. I can see the way that she would win, and I'm gonna give her a 7 out of 10 as well. This fucking man right here is one of the most insane people I have ever heard of. He was imprisoned and wrote a novel on toilet paper. He lived in exile for 22 years from Kenya. He's been robbed and assaulted, and despite all this, he claps the fuck back and has become just about the most acclaimed African author living currently. He's the first indigenous African nominee for the International Booker Prize. He's top of the polls for the Nobel Prize. The second I get my hands on any of his books for anything less than $20, I'm just gonna, you know, his path to victory is just like an achievement for having lived so long, having had any success at all in his condition. So I'm gonna give him a solid 8. I think he's quite possible. Wait, he hasn't won? All right then, 10 out of 10. Look out, kid, no matter what you did, walk on your tip. is she the most annoying person ever to live? Listen, okay, The Handmaid's Tale sucks, alright? I'm sorry to any of you that like it. I'm afraid you're wrong. It sucks. It's bad. She's an awful, awful writer. I think if she wanted to be, like, giving the award to Donna Tartt, she sucks. she's so insistent that what she's saying is timely and clever, and everyone agrees with her. Everyone's been sucked into this fantasy that she's a good writer, when in reality this, of course, is not true. It seems like even the Nobel Academy have been sucked into this. I can't wait to see the nominations open up in 50 years, and we can see the millions of times that she was nominated for this fucking award. It gives me a real savage joy, though, that I don't think she's ever going to win. I really don't. I'm gonna give her a 5 out of 10. I can't imagine giving the same award to her as, like, Doris Lessing, you know? That just sucks. Christ. Better stay away from those that care out of fire hose. Keep a clean nose, wash a clean coat. Don't worry, my friends, I don't want him here either. don't worry, he sucks. We all know this, but he got nominated for that new Academy Award, and even though it would make no sense to give it to him and it'd be a terrible pick, it has now become possible. And I'm gonna give Neil Gaiman a 1 out of 10 for his likelihood, his writing, and just his life in general. His life is fucking crazy, by the way. Can I just go through his wiki for you? Gaiman is married to songwriter and performer Amanda Palmer, whose own bio lists an alternate name as Amanda fucking Palmer, with whom he has an open marriage, at the age of 60, by the way. On 16th November 2010, Palmer hosted a non-legally binding flash mob wedding for Gaiman's birthday in New Orleans. He was born Jewish and raised a Scientologist, which is his family's religion. I haven't edited any of this. I haven't inspected the page. This is just what comes up. About his personal views, Gaiman has said, "I think we can say that God exists in the DC universe." I don't know what that means. I don't know what this means. Does he mean Superman? What does he mean? What does this mean? Oh, he probably means Snyder, the fucking idiot.
I just tend to like human beings. You don't need a weatherman to
know it's where the wind blows. This is another nominee for the new Academy Prize that Maurice Kond won. Yeah, I don't know who the fuck this is. But it makes sense to put her here now. She's only 50, though, which would make her an actual baby in comparison to the codgers that have gotten it. Peter Carey would definitely be the Australian of choice, not any of these two, but an Australian hasn't won in a long time. It even says on his Falcon Wiki, frequently named as Australia's next contender for the Nobel Prize in Literature. He's won the regular Man Booker twice. That's excellent standing to be in. And they would totally love to give it to him in the illusion that they give it to people who aren't European. I think it'll happen in about 10 years from now. I don't think it's happening this year. I'm gonna give him an 8 out of 10. Oh, get sick, get well, hang around and think well, hang well, hard to tell if anything is gonna sell. We're getting kind of into the no man's land here. We're getting into the predictions that no one else makes. But basically, rule of thumb here is that anyone who has won the International Man Booker catapults up the ranking regardless of age or accessibility. And this is the writer of some books that Bellatar has adapted, most notably Satan Tango, which is that famous movie where things happen in it. And he's suitably foreign and unknown enough that they could totally launch themselves at him. He's also got a new book coming out. There's only been one other properly Hungarian winner in 2002, and I'm not even going to try and pronounce that fucking name. So it's not impossible they go for him. But because, again, no one's predicting him, I'm only going to give him a 4. 4 out of 10. But, you know, my reasoning's sound. Get back, ride rail, get jail, jump bail, join the army if you fail. This is my really fucking out there one. Well, no, there's another out there one coming, but this is the most out there one. They've never awarded sci-fi like that. They've given it to Ishiguro, who's basically that. But it's clear from Bob Dylan that they don't care about genre. They don't care. Like, there's no rules to these people, which is why there's no rules to my damn ranking. I think my assertion is correct that if they were going to give it to a sci-fi author, it'd be the one who won the Hugo 3 times in a row. People have subtly thrown around George R. R. Martin, like, at low odds for the prize. He's definitely probably been nominated before. So people agree that this genre writing is possible, even though they're attributing it to someone that I don't think could get it. Because I don't think George R. R. Martin has the consistency of body of work. If he had written Game of Thrones level books for 50 years, he'd be up there. But I don't think he is. I think N.K. Jemisin is a little more likely, and bonus points, she's a woman. So I'm gonna give her, I'm only gonna give her like a 2 out of 10, but she's on there. Look out, kids, you're gonna get hit by losers, cheaters, six-time users. Now this is where we get into my big hypothesizing, boys. I had a long think about this because they gave it to Bob Dylan, and his writing isn't literature, not only because it's bad, but because it doesn't fit the format. Songwriting isn't literature. I'm sorry, it isn't. Like, I don't care that people are making that claim, and I just don't agree. But now that they've done that, we can throw in screenwriting and film directing as a variable for this. If they're gonna do that kind of thing, then those are variables as well. And I had to think about filmmakers that could get it, right? And I made a long list. I thought Charlie Kaufman could be an option until his new book, Ant Kind, sucked penis. I had Mike Lee. I think he's more likely than Ken Loach, and because he's made more. And I would put Mike Lee up there. I had Mikhail Haneker, particularly for The White Ribbon, which is like a classic work of literature, you know, like that's something you'd be assigned in school if it was a book. I had Asghar Farhadi, of course, and I had Hirokazu Koreeda, director of Shoplifters, Our Little Sister, and other Japanese films. Of these 5 or 6, I feel like Hirokazu is like the perfect blend of accessibility and status of recognition, because his movies are very consistent, and if the Academy like one, they're gonna like them all. And I don't know if there's been any proof that they've nominated screenwriters or filmmakers before, but this is my theory on who would win if they were to get nominated. Like, if I had predicted 20 years ago, oh, if they nominate musicians, then my pick would have been Bob Dylan, because, like, duh. And my pick for if they're gonna nominate film is one of these 5, with Koreeda as the standout there. Even so, he's getting a fat 1 out of 10. But if it happened, I'm gonna lose my mind. Thank you all for watching, ladies and gentlemen. Tune in on the 7th of October at 1 p.m. CEST to watch the Nobel Prize in Pretentiousness. I'll upload a short reaction video where I'll hear the name, go, who the fuck's that, and then the video instantly. Thanks for watching, guys.
You. Have you heard the news?
Yep.
You've won the Nobel Prize for Literature.
Oh, crap.
How do you feel?
Well, it's been going on now for 30 years. I can't get more excited.